Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. Watch the video till the end, and if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon. Friends, today we're going to learn a concept which is how to calculate the net worth of the company. We're going to understand the formula and some of the top examples of the same. Well, we'll begin with the same. The net worth of the company is basically, you may heard about the term quite often. I mean, don't you? Especially when the newspaper, the business magazines and the finance journals, they talk about the significant individuals in the financial world. So if you're someone who would like to understand the net worth or wants to find out your own net worth, then in that scenario, what's going to happen is that, you know, this brief guide or this brief tutorial is definitely going to help you. Now, in simple terms, the net worth is the net assets and the earnings is the net assets and the net earnings after you need to deduct all the liabilities and the expenses. So what is the net worth of the company? See, net worth of the company is nothing but the book value of the shareholders' equity of the firm. So it's the shareholders' equity of the firm. Now, the net worth of the company is the value of the assets after paying off its liabilities. So, and the liabilities is sort of like debt. So what we need to note over here that, you know, the net worth is different from the market value of the company, or you can say the market cap. They both are different thing altogether. Well, let's take an example of Apple and Amazon. Now, what we note that, you know, the Apple's net worth is 134.05 billion. And that of Amazon, this is for the Apple's net worth, and for the Amazon's net worth, it's $19.2 billion. So, however, the market capitalization is, this is the net worth, the market cap is 898.5 billion and 592.29 billion for Amazon. Because as you can see over here, the graph of Apple and Amazon, the Apple is in blue and the Amazon's is in red. So the number 134.05 billion and 19.29 billion is here, as you can see. So, well, I showed you the numbers in the graph. Let's understand the formula for net worth. See, the net worth of the company formula is going to be the total assets less the total liabilities. So the above is also known as your shareholders' equity, or you can say the book value. So what we need to note that, you know, this is different from the tangible book value, which also removes the value of the intangible assets, like, you know, the goodwill part, the patents, and so on and so forth. So how to calculate the net worth of the company? Well, let's take an example over here and understand the whole concept. Let's say there's a guy called Mr. A, and Mr. A has a hold of the balance sheet of let's say Q company. But while traveling, Mr. A lost the last part of the balance sheet. So how would you calculate the net worth of the company ABC? I've taken down the detail on the next sheet over here, the assets and the liabilities detail. Well, here the computation is easy. All Mr. A needs to do is to calculate the net worth of the company of ABC by deducting the total liability from the total assets. So we have the details of the assets here, and then we have the detail of the liabilities here. So let's try and evaluate the total assets and liability. The total assets, that is A, is going to be 615. This is going to be a total assets. Right, and the total liability is 315, control R. So once we do, we just need to deduct, find the net worth of the company. Well, that's going to be less 315, that's 58 lakh or 5.8 million and 5.7 million for 2016 and 2015 respectively. Now, how would you interpret the growth or decrease of the net worth? What has happened here? This is an increase in the net worth. But what? How will you evaluate things? See, both for the business and the individual, the assets and liabilities can go down or it can go up. If you see the net worth of the business, well, or as an individual has been growing. Now, we can easily say that, you know, the increase in the assets and the earnings of the business or individual has been more than the increase in the liability and the expenses. Or we can also say that the decrease in the assets and the earning of the business is less than the decrease in the liability of the expenses. So we'll take the increasing net worth of the company example. I'm going to show you the Amazon's net worth, which has been increasing continuously over the past 5 years period, and this is just because they have been able to increase the assets and the earning over the period of time. See the graph down the line here. As you can see, from 2010 onwards to 2016, the $19.2 billion, the net worth is absolutely increasing at a rapid pace. But if you see, you know, the Sears holding, it has a decreasing net worth of the company, a net decreasing trend. This is for the Sears holding book value. As you can see, there's a clear drop down. There's a complete decline, a significant decline in the value of the net worth. It has from 11.25 and closely it is negative to $3.82 billion. So there's a quite drawback, or you can say there's a free fall that we saw for the Sears company. So what is the net worth? I mean, what is the net worth from an individual perspective? See, recently there was a guy called Chris Larson. He was a co-founder of the cryptocurrency company Ripple and has become the fifth wealthiest person in terms of the net worth. Now that we understand that what is net worth of the company, let's look at how the net worth can be calculated of the individual. From the individual perspective, net worth means, you know, the difference between how much a person owns and how much they owes. So as a simple example, let's say that David has a home, a car, and a portfolio investment. So his home is, let's say, is worth of $120,000. The car he owned is, let's say, $20,000, and the portfolio of the investments is standing at $50,000. So he has taken a mortgage loan on this. What has he taken? A mortgage loan for his home, which is around, let's say, $60,000, which has already been paid off, $10,000. So he has also taken a car loan, which is standing at, let's say, $10,000. So what would be the net worth at this very juncture? So this is a quite simple example. All we need to do is add up the assets of the debit and then deduct all the liabilities. So debit's total assets is 1,20,000 plus 20,000 plus 50,000 and plus, that's it. So that's going to be 1,90,000. There's a twist here in the example. It says that out of 60,000, debit has taken a loan of 10,000, right? This has already been paid off. That means at this very moment, the mortgage loan is about 50,000. 60 minus 10. And now we can add up the liabilities. That's going to be 50,000 plus we have 10,000. So the final amount of liability is 60,000. We just need to deduct assets minus liability. That's going to be 1,30,000. This was it for the example on the net worth of the company. That's it for this particular topic.
If you have learned and, you know, liked the video, if you think that, you know, if you have enjoyed and learned watching this video, please like, comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.